Day 2 of the advent of Code 2024 brings another problem on the list of lists. That is what the input looks like. In the first part of the problem, we analyze each list individually. The request is to test whether these two conditions are both satisfied. The numbers in the list must all be either increasing or decreasing. Furthermore, the difference between adjacent numbers is between 1 and 3 inclusively. The request is to count the input list satisfying these conditions. I have already loaded all the lists so that we can start with programming. It would be much easier to contemplate this problem if we had a helper function that checks whether two consecutive elements are safe. It would also be much easier to code the solution if this were an extension method on a pair of consecutive values. The rules are simple. The absolute value of the difference must be at least 1 and at most 3. However, there is also the request to check the sort order. I cannot do that by observing pairs of numbers in isolation. Let me add the value defining the expectation, plus 1 for the ascending order and minus 1 for the descending. The rest is straightforward. The two numbers must appear in the order specified in the argument. There you have it, a helper method that lifts a part of the burden from the method that checks if the entire list is safe. That is the problem we are solving, right? Corner case first. A list with less than 2 elements violates nothing. It is safe. However, a larger list already has a sort order, which I will capture in a more detailed overload. Here is the point in case I sounded confused. The order between all other consecutive elements of the list must be the same as that of the first 2 elements. Do you see how breaking the problem down helps attain focus? This method tests whether the list is safe and has a specific sort order. Believe it or not, I will break the problem down even further. I want to break the list into pairs of successive elements. The pairs will be another extension method on the list. It would return a sequence consisting of all the pairs of successive elements of the list. That will be very useful, you will see. I will deal with it later. Consider it done and enjoy life in which such a method exists so you can check whether all the pairs of successive list elements satisfy a condition. What condition? Well, the condition that the pair is safe given the expected sort order. Programming is easy when all the methods you need already exist. Sometimes it will be your task to implement those helpers. A method that returns pairs of successive elements is a well-known example of consuming the iterator design pattern. Take the enumerator. Quit if there is nothing in the list. Remember the first element otherwise. That will be the first previous value. Then consume the rest of the list. Emit each new element with its predecessor. Set the new predecessor. It is done. We can finally answer the question from the problem. How many safe lists are there? Oh, that is easy. Just count the lists where isSafe returns true. Everything in programming is easy when there are methods that do the work you need to be done. We move on to the second part of day 2. Every list is now allowed to contain one number that breaks the sequence. Suppose we encountered an error at some position. Which element has caused it? There are several optimized strategies to try to figure out the culprit. However, there is no indication that the lists we are processing are large. Why not try using brute force instead? There is one technique common in search algorithms. We expand the current state into all states that could possibly follow and then check if any of those contain the solutions we seek. Given a list, the sequence of lists we should consider includes that list. Then it includes all the lists we can create by removing one element from the starting one. How do I produce those modified lists? Here is one take on that problem. Enumerate indices of all the elements in the list. Then for each index, produce a modified list with an element at that index removed. How nice! The accept at method does not exist yet. But you have already learned that any such method is probably just one additional line of code. Take all the elements before the desired index. Concatenate all the elements past it. Collect into a new list. This entire operation is quite efficient, even for a list of a significant size. A side note, you can use the method group in cases like this rather than a lambda. But that was just a detail. The real pleasure awaits us above, where we must count the safe lists with the tolerance of up to one error. It will be easy, trust me. We start by counting the lists just like before, but this time we expand each list into many candidates. And we ask if any of those is safe. If so, then the list we are treating is safe too, because it was either safe already or has become safe after removing one element. This is the entire solution to day 2. You don't have to type any of this code by hand to try it. Visit me on Patreon and find the link to the repository, where you can read solutions for all 25 days for free. You can also stay around and watch more advanced videos on C# on my channel. We can now move to solving the day 3 problem.